Welcome back to the Home Assistant Beginner's Guide. In this one, we're going to be adding devices to our Home Assistant server. We're going to look at some of the ways you can customize your devices and control them through Home Assistant. For this video, I'm going to be using the Casa Wi-Fi Smart LED bulbs. Now, you don't have to use these. The reason I'm using them is because they're highly compatible with Home Assistant, and it should give you a pretty good idea how to integrate most devices throughout Home Assistant. So with that out of the way, let's get started. When you're adding new devices to Home Assistant, you first need to connect it to your Wi-Fi network. In the case of the smart bulb, that's done through the TP-Link Casa Smart Home app. And once the bulb is connected to my Wi-Fi network, I then name it in the app. That just makes it easier to identify in Home Assistant. So now that we've set up our bulb through the Casa Smart Home app and is connected to our Wi-Fi network, Home Assistant can find it. So let's set it up. Go down to Configuration and click on Devices and Services. Now your page may look different than mine, and that's okay. This is just showing everything that Home Assistant has found that's connected to your Wi-Fi network. To add our smart bulb, we're going to click on Add Integration, and then in the search box, we're going to type in Casa. And you can leave this box blank and click Submit. And this is searching for all devices that are through the Casa app on my Wi-Fi network. And as you can see, it found several different devices, but right now we're just going to go ahead and set up our studio bulb. And now we can select an area. There are some areas already provided by Home Assistant, but if you need to add a new area, just click there, and then you can call it whatever it is you want. And then just click Finish. And that's actually it for adding devices to Home Assistant, but I'm going to show you how to change the icon, rename the device, or move it to a different area if you ever need to. And you may have noticed that our one smart bulb added one device and three entities. We'll explain the differences between device and entities here in a moment. First, let's just look at the one device, which is our studio bulb, right? If we click on this, we'll see more information about it, including the firmware of the bulb, the sensors that are associated with the bulb, and any sort of automation scenes or scripts that we may add. Here we can rename the bulb, change the area that it's located in, or we can even disable the entity if for some reason we didn't want to use it with Home Assistant anymore. If you disable it, it'll still be there, so you can always re-enable it later. And if we go back to our overview tab, we'll actually see that Home Assistant went ahead and added two cards for us. One showing our studio card, everything that's associated with the studio, as well as our light card, which is our studio bulb light. Here, we can actually even turn on and off our bulb, and we can change different settings, including the brightness of our bulb, as well as the color temperature, or even just the color of the bulb if we wanted to go with some crazy colors. Now, let's say you don't like the icon that's included with the bulb. There are a few different options of what you can do. We can click on this gear cog right here, and we can change the icon. You can scroll through all the different icons that are included in Home Assistant. I'm going to select this ceiling light icon. And you may have noticed that this is a dynamic icon, meaning if I change the settings of my bulb, the icon will also change. I have another video going over how to customize your Home Assistant dashboard. So for right now, let's go to the area that we created, our studio. We're going to go down to Configuration, click on Device and Services, but this time we're going to go to Areas. Here we'll see the studio that we created, and we can see all the devices, entities, scenes, and scripts and automations that we have associated with our studio. We can also rename the studio, and we can add a picture of our studio. And that about does it for adding any smart home devices to Home Assistant. If you have any questions, feel free to leave a comment down below or check out the other videos in my Getting Started with Home Assistant guide, where I cover everything from creating automations, making custom Home Assistant dashboards, and so much more. With that, I'll see you in the next one.